But what I like about this is, like, it's early in the morning, it's 10 o'clock. I am up. You're probably asleep. It's Sunday. You're probably like, nah, I'm not getting up and go do nothing. I don't feel that way. I'm finna get up and get some money. You know what I'm saying? And it's not a lot of money, but it makes me feel good. And it's been helping me lose weight. And I'm not going to knock something that's been working for me. So yep. I just encourage everybody else. This is like the best. You mean to tell me you're going to pay me to take food to you? Bring food to you? Is that what you're telling me? Gonna give me like $5 or $6, maybe $7. Hey, I've had 15, I've had 45. You're gonna tip me to bring you food in the morning, and then I'm gonna lose weight because I'm moving my fat ass? Is that what you're telling me today? Shit, let's get it. That's what I'm on type shit. Gang, and we back with another video. If you're watching this video, you are up to date. This is a new video. One would say, why do you DoorDash or why do you Grubhub every day? But the funny part is, since I've been Grubhubbing and DoorDashing every day, I done lost weight. And the reason why I done lost weight is because I'm constantly in and out the car. I had to climb 3 flights of steps yesterday. I was walking a mile down the beach. I'm constantly going from place to place delivering food. And for me, it's actually helped me lose weight because I'm active every day and I do it every morning. So I make about $40, $50, you know what I'm saying? But I'm active as hell and I really enjoy it. Yeah, so the fact that I'm like constantly, and right now I'm just sitting in a hot spot right now. I'm gonna flip the camera. I'm sitting in a hot spot, you know. Family Dollar, Wingstop, you get the idea. Pizza place. Yeah, so I'm sitting in a hot spot. Another reason why I like Grubhub and DoorDash is because for a big guy like myself, it gets me moving. And you would think it's the worst thing you could do because it's food always in the car. It will make you hungry, but actually it's the opposite. Because I see so much food and because I'm around so much food, I'm not hungry. I actually don't want anything to eat. You know, a lot of times I'll get up and be like, I'm straight. You know, I'll have something to drink and I'm gone about my day. Or if I do get something to eat, it's something meager or small, man. You know, like I was doing the McDonald's thing for a while and you're probably saying McDonald's is trash. Right. But if you eat one McDouble versus eating a whole meal, at least you're doing better. You know, everybody will jump in your comments and talk about, don't do this and don't do that. But you got to remember, it's you didn't get fat that way. Eating a lot of shit. A lot of little shit, a lot. You know what I'm saying? So I gotta reverse that. I don't have my normal mouse like I used to, so I apologize. But you know, it's really nice to get up in the morning, go out here and make some money, and just be active. And like I said, I do get in a nice little sweat, and I have my little Gatorade, zero Gatorade, no sugar. And if you think there, if you have a suggestion for something else that I can drink other than soda or juice, you know, always jump in the comments. And yeah, you're going to say water. Yeah, but we all know you get tired of water. I am not going to fake the funk with myself. You know, I don't drink water. I drink water every day, but I don't drink water religiously. Like, I will not drink nothing else. Like, come on, man. Be real. I'm not going to fake the funk. I'm not going to fake it for the camera. Yeah, I drink soda sometimes. You know, yeah, I've had... You know what I'm saying? So, that's what I'm on type shit. You know what I'm saying? Then I work nights too. So then I also get me like a mile or two in. Now I'm in this group and they're going to get on my head because I ain't been posting my success and posting my situation because I'm supposed to be in this 30-mile challenge on the NRC called the Nike Run Club. Jump in it if you want to. Holler at me. It's good fun. I can add you to the group. We get it in. But I was on vacation and I wasn't posting nothing. I was walking to the fridge and back, but you know what I'm saying? Vacation's over and it's time to get back to it. Actually, today's my last day of vacation, but I couldn't help it. I said, let's get outside. What I don't like about Grubhub is, boy, they send you, now they send you more orders than DoorDash, way more orders, but they be everywhere and it don't show you your mileage on the bottom of the screen. And maybe it does and I don't know where it's at, but I don't be seeing it. You know what I'm saying? Now, because I know the area, I kind of can guess how far it is. But like I said, if I say anything wrong, y'all can always check me in the comments. But I get way more Grubhub orders than I get DoorDash. It's just that Grubhub orders be everywhere. Everywhere. They'll send you orders while you on an order. Now, I am multi-apping now. I use both of them. I have picked up two orders at the same time. I have, picked up one and went and got the other one. Or I just had them both at the same time because they were going the same way. I've never had orders that were going the same, going a different direction. You know, I don't think I would do something like that. But I have made it on time. I haven't gotten no orders that I was just pure ass late, you know what I'm saying, or whatever. But I did realize that when you pick up a DoorDash order, how does it go? Okay, if you pick up a Grubhub order and let's say you're going a different direction, you know, than what is specified on the cell phone, it will keep sending you alerts. I thought it was the people doing that, like the customer, but it's DoorDash. Say, oh, you're going the wrong way, or you're going away other than specified. Please turn around. Please do the order. That shit's annoying. You know what I'm saying? So you damn kind of want to go deliver Grubhub first. But I do it in the time that I got it. So if I had got DoorDash first and DoorDash is not as close as the Grubhub order, I'm going to go do the DoorDash first because that's the first one I picked up and I got to get it to them at a certain time. If it's the Grubhub order, it's really much you really can't do with that. Now, if the Grubhub was a lot closer than the DoorDash, now I would go do the Grubhub first. But for me, it ain't been the case like that. Whatever one I pick up first is the one I deliver first. You go multi-app is to probably do one at a time and pause the other one. I think that's the safest way of doing it. You know, because you don't want to get you don't want to be late and you don't want to get no bad marks and get deactivated on your thing. But like, as far as like working out, man, and just like just moving around, you know what I'm saying? Because you don't know. Sometimes it's elevator, sometimes it's steps. Sometimes you don't have an option, you know what I'm saying? So I went to situations where the elevator was broken. I had to take the steps. And yeah, I could call them and they answer the phone and can you come downstairs? But the majority of people just are lazy as hell. Another thing that I would like to mention is, and it's cool, it kind of works in with my situation, me working out and your health, is that you get to see a lot of different food places. You get to see where other people are eating at. It exposes you to different areas to work out in and different, because I just seen so many different places in a day. Like, that's a lot of juice bars and it's a lot of healthy places that people are going to in the morning. You know what I'm saying? That they're ordering. I don't really get a lot of fast food places, but I get a lot of healthy shit, man. It's a lot of people just on this healthy life. And I get it, it's Florida, it makes sense. But I didn't know about these places. A lot of little juice bars and it's a lot of little breakfast shops that it's made me, if not start cooking at home, or hey babe, when we go out, let's go grab a snack here. This is a little bit more cleaner than what we're used to, where we from, and how we've been eating since we got here. So that's another thing that I enjoy so much that they have going on here, is that people are eating cleaner. You know, people are doing very well and doing way better than I am. Gives me an opportunity to walk inside somebody's establishment. First, I can see if they clean. Secondly, I can make a choice of, hey, would I like to come back here? And a few places I have, you know, it's a few places that I plan on dining in. You know what I'm saying? So this has all been positive for me. Very positive. And the one thing I like about the multi-apping is, especially when you got them hooked to the same debit card, it don't matter which one you do now. So it's like, I'll take $5 over here and $20 over here and $30 over here. It don't even matter, because when I push cash out, I'm getting money from, it's all going to the same thing. So it don't even matter. It don't be like, oh, well, I only made money over here. Nope, I made it as a whole. And that's the only thing that matters. So that's one thing I like about multi-apping. Multi-apping is, well, if they had this when I was a lot younger, I've been a fool with them. You know what I'm saying? I've been a fool out here, boy, I tell you. Because this is, it's nice. It's a nice little income. You ain't got no money. You broke. Now, I do it because I just like to have some bread. It's quick cash. Every day, quick cash. And that shit just add up. And then I might go check out some places, or I might just be out and about, or I want to go do my workout. This is great. Little stuff like that, man. It usually just be where you go. IHOPs are slow. Denny's are slow. At nighttime, McDonald's is slow. Sorry about the camera. I really can't say KFC is slow. I only know one KFC. But they just slow. Dunkin' is fast as hell. I do more Dunkin's. I do more breakfast places. All the breakfast places are pretty quick. Now in the morning, Denny's is fast. IHOP is still slow. I don't care what time you go to IHOP, it's slow. It is just slow. But I noticed something this time. They had a hell of a orders. I walked to IHOP today. They had hella online orders. Wasn't nobody inside. So I'm learning. It could be the weather, but I'm learning that, like, that's just what it is, man. People don't want to dine in. They just want their food and go. So that's no tips for y'all, because y'all are slow. Like, maybe they need to get more staff, or I don't know what the situation is. But I do walk into a lot of establishments like Buffalo Wild Wings, Wingstop, and it may be because of the young crowd, but they playing around, they doing other shit, and it's like, bro, that's how you get paid. So I was going to pick up another order somewhere else. If people don't come eat at your establishment, or people don't want to eat here because y'all slow, then they going to just use less of y'all or find other ways, like robots or some shit. I don't know. I'm rambling. Anyway, Grubhub is winning, I'm telling you. But that's really pretty much what I got for y'all, man. Like I said, off the dome, I ain't trying to waste your time. Just tell you what I'm experiencing. I would definitely multi-app if you can. Try it out. Like I said, do one, pause the other one. Or for Grubhub, just don't answer none of them. I'm on another job. And then as soon as you're done, jump back to the next one. That's exactly how I would do it. And you may come up a lot faster, especially if you got them going to the same debit card like I do. So it's like cha-ching, you know what I'm saying? What I don't get from one, I get to the other. And then you don't feel so bad about being out here all day. Like, I'd be out here all day, 3 hours, and I only work for 1 hour, and I only probably got like 10 to 15 bucks. Well, I don't feel like that no more, because if I'm out here all day, now I might have, and this is true, on DoorDash, I only have like $10, $15. But on Grubhub, I probably got like 40, 50. I haven't checked, but I know it's up in the 40s. You know what I'm saying? It's only been 2 hours. So then you combine those together, you'd be like, oh, damn, your boy up 60. So, you know, it works like that.
Living.